there's a problem with enclosed cube-style 3D printers that have the spool holder on the back. It's super awkward to get the filament loaded and unloaded because you can't see what you're doing. The spool holder's on the back, the filament actually goes into the back of the printer, and so the big problem is that you've got a whole printer in your way when you want to add filament. When the printer's on a shelf or a workbench or a countertop, you have to pull the printer away from the wall and spin it around to do the filament thing. Well, keep watching and I'll show you a cheap and super easy fix that will definitely make living with one of these printers a lot easier. I'm Brian, and you are watching BV3D. Hello, 3D printing friends, and welcome back. Okay, so today we're putting an end to the annoyance of having to spin and move your 3D printer around just to get a spool of filament loaded. If you have one of these types of printers, you know exactly what I'm talking about, right? People with regular i3 style bed slingers have it so easy when it comes to swapping or loading filament. The spool goes on top or on the side, and the filament feeds into the top or the side, and it's just so dang easy and convenient. Meanwhile, we're over here dreading when that last bit of filament goes into the printer. Not that you'd know when that moment was coming. I mean, you can't even see the spool. So you start a print, and then surprise, 20 minutes in, your printer's filament runout sensor stops the show and says, "Hey, you need to run out and get more." So here's the cheap and easy fix. Ta-da! A printable spool holder you can park next to the printer. Huh? Okay, that's only half of the fix. The other half is this plain old PTFE tubing that's super common in 3D printing. A 1 meter length of this is well under 10 bucks on Amazon, and it's enough for two or three printers, and there's a link in the description. Now, this particular tubing has a 3 millimeter inside diameter instead of the usual 2 millimeter inside diameter. The printer's gonna be pulling filament through it, so I just want it to have a relaxed, comfortable fit. And that's just my personal preference. Now, if you already have the usual kind with the 2 millimeter inside diameter and 4 millimeter outside diameter, that is definitely fine. So here's how this works. Spin your printer around so you're looking at the back of it. Then take a look at where the filament goes into the printer. Most likely, it's feeding directly into a filament runout sensor. The Creality K1 is like this, and so is the Chiditech X-Max 3. The Core XY printers from Bamboo Lab, operating in single color mode without an AMS or automatic material system, are similar. The main difference with the Bamboo Lab printers is that the filament runout sensor is built into the tool head and not mounted at the back. But for all of these, there is a PTFE coupler. And if your printer has one, well, this is your lucky day because this solution will work for you too. Now, here's how to get it set up. First, print yourself a standalone spool holder. There are approximately 27 million of them on your favorite 3D model site. I like this one. It's jjpowelly's Universal Spool Holder, and it dates back to 2015, believe it or not. It's nice because you can print different widths for it, so you can make one that handles wide spools and one that handles narrow spools. And it's got printed threads and captive nuts to connect all the parts, so there's no glue or tools or hardware needed to put it together. This one fits the vast majority of my needs. But look around. There may be one designed for your specific printer, like this one that's designed to hang on the side of the Creality K1. Now, once you've got a spool holder printed, connect one end of this PTFE tubing to the coupler on the back of the printer that I showed you a minute ago. Then, cut it to length using a hobby knife or a utility knife so you get a clean edge on the end of the tubing. Don't use flush cutters. They'll just crush the tubing as they cut it. So, what's the right length? It's whatever you need it to be to comfortably feed filament. I like to have it come about halfway around the side of the printer, and that's what works for me. Well, then, load your filament. Cut a 45 degree angle on the end of it and feed it through the tube, past the filament sensor, and then the rest of the way into the printer. Use your printer's filament loading method, and once you see the filament coming out of the nozzle, you'll be ready to print. So that's my solution to the problem of rear-mounted spools on these enclosed cube-style printers. For me, it makes loading filament into these printers a much more pleasant experience. If you liked this episode, give it a thumbs up and maybe subscribe so you don't miss new ones. Big thanks to everyone who supports the channel, whether with channel memberships or by using the links in the description. Well, 3D printing friends, that's about all the time we have for this one. And now that we're at the end, let's go print something cool.